Welcome to Institute of Quality and Reliability. Hi, this is Hemant. We recommend that the viewer should see our previous two videos, DOE-1 and DOE-2 on design of experiments before watching this video. In the first video on introduction to design of experiments, we have explained how to design a simple two-factor, two-level experiment and analyze the results of the experiment. Analysis included calculation of main effects and interactions. In the second video, DOE-2, we have seen how to design a three-factor, two-level experiment and analyze the results of the experiment. We have illustrated the procedure with a case study on spot welding process. Please recall from our previous videos that effect of a factor can be calculated as average response at high level of the factor minus average response at low level of the factors. In this particular cube, the four corners of the face with red color were all at high level of factor A, and the four corners of the face of the cube with blue color face were all at low level of factor A. You can also recall interpretation of interaction plots. In figure 1, there is no interaction. In figure 2, mild interaction. Figure 3 shows strong interaction, and figure 4 also shows strong interaction. In the previous video, in the spot welding experiment example, levels of the three factors were as shown in the table below. These are uncoded levels. Remember that coded values are minus 1 for low level and plus 1 for high level of the factors, and therefore the table of coded values for this experiment can be seen in black color. Conversion of uncoded to coded values. Consider the factor time. Low level setting is 10 and high level setting is 16. Corresponding coded values are minus 1 and plus 1 respectively. The coded values of 0 therefore corresponds to uncoded value of 13, which is the center point. The difference of two coded units corresponds to 6 uncoded units, and therefore one coded unit corresponds to 3 uncoded units. Thus we can convert any uncoded value to coded value with the equation time coded equal to time uncoded minus 13 divided by 3. For example, at high level time is equal to 16, therefore time coded can be calculated as plus 1, and at the low level, that is time is equal to 10, time coded can be minus 1. For example, at time 15, we can calculate the coded value as 15 minus 13 by 3, that is equal to plus 0.66. Or at time is equal to 12, coded value will be 12 minus 13 by 3, that is minus 0.33. Similarly, uncoded value of force can be converted into coded value with the equation force coded is equal to force uncoded minus 3 divided by 1. Try converting interim values of force of 3.5 to coded value. And for current, the conversion formula will be current coded is equal to current uncoded minus 10 upon 1. Here you can try conversion of value of current is equal to 9.4 to a coded unit. It is also easy to convert coded values to uncoded values. For time, the equation is the time coded equals time uncoded minus 13 upon 3. Therefore, time uncoded can be equated as 3 times time coded plus 13. Similarly, force uncoded equals force coded plus 3, and current uncoded equals current coded plus 10. Consider an example of time And let us say that the coded value of this setting is minus 0.2. Therefore, the uncoded value can be calculated as 3 times time coded plus 13, that is 3 into minus 0.2 plus 13, and we can get 12.4 as the setting corresponding to minus 0.2. Now we will see how to develop a regression equation from the calculation of main effects and interactions. Here is a table of main effects and interactions for the welding experiment discussed in the previous video, DOE-2. For coded level plus 1, that is high level, the average values were as shown, and for coded level minus 1, the average values were as shown, and the effects are calculated as shown in the table. From the above table of effects, we have to develop a linear regression equation to predict y, that is the response, with the following terms. Y cap is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1 plus beta 2 x2 and so on. So this is the equation where the beta 0, beta 1, beta 2 are all constants, and x1, x2, x3, etc. are the settings of the individual factors A, B and C. From the table of effects shown on the previous slide, we can develop a linear regression equation to predict y in the following form. The main effect plot of time is reproduced here for reference. The coefficient beta 1 for time in coded units can be calculated as slope of the main effect plot, which is delta y by delta x, where delta y is the effect of time on strength, while as delta x is the change in time in coded units. The effect of time on strength is delta y, that is 146, while as delta x in coded units is 2 coded units. Thus beta 1 equals half of delta y, that is 146 by 2, that is 73. Similarly, as delta x in coded units will always be 2, all coefficients in coded units will be half of the corresponding effect. Thus, coefficient for force, that is beta 2, will be 58.5 by 2, that is 29.25, and coefficient for current will be beta 3, that is 117 by 2, that is 58.5. The following table shows coefficients as half the main effect and interactions. Finally, the constant term beta 0 can be calculated as average of all responses in the experiment. It can be seen that beta 0 for the spot welding experiment is 336.5. This can be considered as the expected response when all factors are set at their center point, when their coded values are 0 and the value of predicted response reduces to beta 0. Thus, the regression equation for predicted value of strength is given by strength is equal to 336.5 plus 73 x1 plus 29.25 x2 plus 58.5 x3 minus 1.25 x1 x2 plus 3.75 x2 x3 plus 11 x1 x3 plus 2.25 x1 x2 x3. Remember, this is the predicted value. We can also develop regression equation in uncoded units. The regression equation in coded units is shown below. We have already established equations to convert coded values to uncoded values of each factor. And these are the equations, where C indicates coded and UC indicates uncoded values. We can substitute these values of coded variables in the above equation to get the following relationships. Similarly, if we substitute all values and simplify, we can get the regression equation in uncoded units. And here are all the relationships. Simplifying these terms gives us the equation in uncoded units. As this can become tedious, usually it is solved using software.
In this video, we have seen how to convert uncoded units to coded units of factor levels and vice versa. We have also seen how to create regression equation in coded as well as uncoded units. Thanks for watching this video. Hope you found it worth watching. Please subscribe to Institute of Quality and Reliability channel if you want to watch more videos on reliability engineering, Six Sigma, and statistical quality control. Thank you.